Hey, what's up, guys? I'm Hunter IC. Welcome back. Episode 2, Demon's Souls Walkthrough. Now, we're actually beginning this episode not where I said we were going to. I had I changed my mind because this is simply the smarter way to go. We're in the Shrine of Storms here. And, you're going to be contending with lots of skeletons in this area. Now, I actually started this maybe a little bit too soon. We're in human form, and if you die in human form, it shifts the world tendency towards black. And if I remember, I will include a nice pure black world tendency event with you guys. I have that footage recorded. I'll still have to cast it, but I can show you guys that. Now we're going to take our time going through 4-1 here. The beginning parts here are undoubtedly tricky, and I'm gonna have to be quite careful overall. Now, what are we gonna be covering here? We're actually running a really interesting route. Try to predict, you know, for those of you who have even played the game, try to predict, you know, where I'm gonna go. There's so many different paths you can take in this level, and lots of hidden stuff, some of which I will be sharing with you guys. So okay, I'm feeling pretty good at this point. We have not actually attracted the attention of these other skeletons. So we got the thief's ring on, of course. That's why these guys can't see us. If we move a little bit closer, they will. I've also got heal. I should keep that in mind, I guess. Let's just throw on a talisman, because we got free room to use. So we'll throw that on if we want to use a heal instead of grass. We can do that too. Now this is really the last hard part.
This isn't good.
Okay, you know what? I was gonna not actually include that. I was gonna edit that out, but nah. Let's do this. This is what we do. We run. Okay. Evading the first guy. This is actually one of the hardest things to do. These guys have seemingly infinite stamina, and they can just continuously roll, and of course, their rolls do damage. So far, I've timed my rolls flawlessly, and I'm thrilled that we just got by them all. That's undoubtedly a very frustrating part. Now this is actually tricky as well. Let's sprint, right? Sprint? Am I dead? No, I'm good. Oh, I might be dead, guys. I'm dead. Oh, Jesus. Come on, right? I'm good. Let's just pop some grass. Okay. We're in good shape now. This guy's just rolling around the bottom here. Okay, so the next step in Demon's Souls in episode 2 is to do exactly what I just did, whether you want to kill off all those enemies or try and run by them. That was a really tricky run by. You can, you know, go back and see maybe five nicely timed rolls, because, you know, you're only invincible in the middle of that roll animation. But I timed it well. Okay, this is our number one goal here. In fact, I'm actually so... I want to be careful, you know. I have kind of a track record now for just maybe not doing a good enough job of taking my time, and thus, you know, if I died right now, that'd be extremely frustrating. So we're just going to play it perfectly safe, get by that guy, and oh, you just saw a quick flash of the item there. I think you may know what it is. This, even with a backstab, this does so little damage. Okay, 28 damage backstab. Now, let's do an experiment. We will come down here. Why am I... Oh, of course, because I put the shield on. That's why I'm rolling slow. Now, we actually want to switch on our new weapon. Crescent Falchion +1. And now, the fact that I didn't kill off these guys earlier, you know, it's coming back to bite me a bit. But this is a great weapon, and I wanted to really stress this so much. You know, pick up Demon's Souls on PS3. Like, it is the best game on PS3, and it's, like, really cheap. It's, like, the cheapest you can get new games, you know, like $15 or $20, here at least, Canada. So pick it up, and if you're playing it, and if you want to know the great weapon to get very quickly and easily, it's this one here. I mean, we did it quite fast. So we've got our weapon of choice, Crescent Falchion. We'll be using it for a little while, at least. Let me see. There's so many... Oh, I'm dead, guys. Sorry. There's so many other... I'm actually really cheesy right now. I really was not... I was getting too excited about the find and this new weapon. And, you know, not focused enough on the gameplay. But we'll chop through these guys much faster now. God, am I gonna die again? No chance. Okay, we also have this weapon, which is only 1.5 weight, and the one we were using before, 3.5. So that frees up enough for us to use our shield, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, that's all fine. I can even run... No, maybe not a helm. No, nothing else. Soon, though. So we'll keep this set up. I do want to show you guys the sword, of course. Let's see why it's so good. I mean, you got physical attack is at 67. And then you get an additional 82, well, plus 8. So you get an additional 90 magical attack. So 90 plus 67 total damage, which is way more than what we were doing with that halberd, despite the fact that, you know, this is smaller, lighter, you can swing so quickly. It's not like a clunky, heavy halberd. Yeah, they're just different weapon types, and I mean, this one, you know, has gone down that crescent path, and that's the smith system in Demon's Souls. I'm not actually at all familiar with it, to be completely honest. Definitely want to grab these souls. Actually, it wasn't quite as many as I thought. Oh my god, I'm doing it again! No! 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 Okay, whatever. You know, we're not even 10 minutes deep. It's all good. We can just continue on from here. It's a hard game. It is a hard game. It's not going to stop us, though. So yeah, this weapon's got some nice build-up as well, actually. Let's just take a look. Does it do bleed? Special effects, yeah. So that, like, everything in Demon's Souls is all symbols. You can see all the symbols that we have representing all different stuff in the game. And you actually just eventually kind of learn what all the symbols mean. So, yeah, 120 bleed. Which, you know what, guys? Let's do a little activity with bleed. I'll just show you what it looks like on a boss. I'm so bad at this game, guys. Like, I just have to say that. Well, I have played so poorly at this game. But I think we're making a comeback here, and I can show you everything else that I want to show you. Some important grabs coming up. For one here is... we're good. For one here is a zone that you can pick up lots of really useful items. Man, there is a lot of these guys. These guys constantly. You know what? Okay, you know what? I've been doing wrong, I think. I think I've just been two-handing it. No way! Are you serious? I think I've been two-handing it a little bit too much. Okay, you know what? We're just farming a few souls here. Oh, man. We're still within the 10-minute mark. We're good. We're good. Alright, should we do another run-by? I want to grab the Adjudicator Shield. Oh, do we really want to gamble a run-by at this point? No, I don't think so. Let's just do this for real. Okay, let's do this textbook. Here we go. Oh yeah, right. There's no riposte? Okay. Ooh, I do wish I had a certain ring right now. A ring that we'll pick up later in the video. Oh man, it is frustrating. They seem to design this level so that really the toughest challenge is right at the beginning, pretty much. Like, it doesn't get much harder than all the guys you run into. in this portion. Okay, we got this archer here. Get him to overzealous. Alright, only two left. Well, plus this archer, he actually, are you serious? Kind of repositioned himself over there. I'm gonna start using some mana to heal. I've been just using up a lot of grass. Why don't we also, oh, that animation takes quite a while. Why don't we also take a look at what's here? Okay, that's good. We've been using up lots of that. Be good to replace it. Back to the shield. At least I've had no double deaths. You know, you don't actually lose any progress, in theory, as long as you don't die two times in a row. But that can be a real headache. In the most, or like, I don't know, episode 6 of the latest Dark Souls walkthrough, season, there's a part where my soul sign disappears and I lose like 55,000 souls when it was truly a glitch. Apparently it happens sometimes. Oh, really frustrating though. And it can be, and it certainly has potential in Demon Souls as well. Alright guys, we're gonna just finish killing these guys off, farming a few extra souls, and I think now we should be good, all clear. So our next target really is the Adjudicator Shield. So why don't we just go for that first? That's like, okay. We've got Vanguard here as well. Now earlier I mentioned about bleed. So why don't we take a look at how it works on this boss? I didn't actually show it in this playthrough, but there is an optional tutorial at the beginning of. No. There is an optional tutorial at the beginning, and the boss of that tutorial is, well, it's Vanguard here. Yeah, he goes by the same name, I'm sure. I'm so tempted to run by. I guess we have to run by, guys. No, we don't. Forget it. Run by. Running by is so stupid. You know what, I'm glad we got this sword, though. Sword is a big improvement upon what we were working with before. Now, I guess bleed, I don't know if it... Maybe it doesn't work with on these skeletons. Oh, shit, I almost died there. Well, it wouldn't actually make much of a difference, because these guys have low health anyway, compared to boss fight. I mean, you can hear me mashing that out, Eddie. Okay, two left, once again. No. Okay, we're good. No, that wasn't fair. That wasn't fair. That was unfair. Oh, I was locked on to the guy who was falling off a cliff. I was still swinging at him, but I knew not to swing too much, so I stopped. And then this fucking buddy sticks his falchion, like, straight up this guy's ass. It's awful. That's exactly what happened, though. Look at the replay, man. It was bad. It was bad, and it pushed me right off the cliff. It's our first cliff death, and a costly one. One that, well, cost us a grand total of, I don't know, 3,000 souls? That's actually very little. And all of a sudden, an episode of this Demon Souls walkthrough that I thought was going to be one of the easier ones has really given me just a ton of problems. Man, these swings from this weapon, one-handed, have some like weird reactions. I don't know, I swung at him once, but it hit him like three times, sort of. I'm gonna push this guy, or I don't even have to. He's suicidal. Where are you off to, my friend? Oh, he's trying to get in better range for his bow. okay, guys, we're in good shape once again. Although, I think I said this exact thing last time we were here. At least these are pretty quick, like, you know, this is a tough spot, but it's right at the beginning of the level. So, it doesn't actually take too long, feeling better about it. Oh, that last swing missed. Okay, here we are. I want to actually be careful. How much, what's my, sorry, item burden? Okay, we've got lots of room there. Alright, we're going the same way. I still want to show you guys bleed. Okay, so you need to hit him. I'm alive! I'm lucky. So I guess as long as I have full health, it's sometimes he's not going to one-shot me. Okay, let's see if we can get by. See? He's bleeding. That's what I wanted to show you. Okay, let's get out of here. Okay. See, you can see he's still taking damage. And, well, blood's kind of flying everywhere. So that'll just go on for a while. So it's nice against bosses, but unless the enemy has a lot of health, you know, you're usually going to use it, I guess. Okay, this is another pivotal part, of course. What is that? What? Oh, that's the tail of one of those flyers. Oh, man. It's kind of an odd glitch. Okay. Let's heal once again. I'm not exactly sure how I want to approach this. It's a tough part, you know? And if I die, I have to start at the beginning, which really sucks. Okay, do I have... Oh, yeah, there's some unused full moon grass there. Okay, cool. And we've got the item burden. I told a story in the first episode about how item burden screwed me over, and it was actually at this... Oops, I didn't mean to do that. It was actually at this exact part. It prevented me from getting the shield that we're trying to get. Okay, let's see what we can do. Shouldn't be a problem, right? We got it. I don't care if I die. Well, actually, that's not completely true. Oh, Jesus. I'm still alive. I wasn't actually sure what the net result of all that stuff was going to be, but I was alive with just a little bit of health, and we're safe now. Okay. And now, I get to show you, I may call it my favorite item in the game. As of now, I'm actually not super familiar with most, with a lot of the items in this game. But this is a really good one. The Adjudicator Shield. And the reason why it's so great is just that one line at the bottom there. So, it starts at +2 per second. And then you can upgrade it with colorless demon souls, and you can upgrade it all the way to +8 HP per second, I think, which is really huge, and it can stack with the regenerator's ring, which is a ring that I referenced earlier. And well, it can, you know, add up to a whole bunch of, item regeneration. Sorry, life regeneration. Okay, so we can crush these guys two-handed, you know, emptying our whole stamina there. So as long as they're one-on-ones, we should be okay. And yes, we have to keep in mind the fire from those, like, flying manta rays. Quite annoying. Okay, two of them down. And this one you have to lure. I remember once upon a time when there was actually multiplayer in this game. This would be a spot where somebody would leave a message tipping you off, you know, lure it out. or whatever, referring to this guy. Because, you know, you're not going to want to engage him on that small ledge there. You know? And all the while, I'm getting some life regeneration. You can see I'm actually glowing in blue. Well, yeah, you can probably see it a little bit. Let's examine my blue glow while this guy is going to butcher chop my head off. Oh, no. Oh, you did it. Oh, okay, you know what? That's not the end of the world. It's really not. In fact, I don't know. May, in the long run, prove to be even easier now. I don't know. Maybe that's a bit far-fetched. But I can show you a very important shortcut that leads you straight to that regenerator's ring. So we'll just take two different paths. And the thing is, I mean, we do have a few items we're getting. We got to get the Crescent Falchion. We got it. The Adjudicator Shield we got now. And the Regenerator's Ring. So it's three items, and you got to kind of go in three completely separate directions. In fact, it's impossible to get this shield that I just found and the Regenerator's Ring if you take that Regenerator's shortcut. So, I don't know. It's good to see the shortcut as well. It's very useful. Like, cuts off the vast majority of the level. Now, I should definitely play around with this shield's bash. Why don't we try it? Oh, sweet. Not bad. Killed him off. I mean, you know, in some cases, they're standing too close to the ledge, maybe. You bash them off the cliff. But really, we're just in it for the life regen. And if I can get my hands on some of those... Shoot. Some of those colorless demon souls. Then, yeah, we'll definitely be investing in my shield. I mean, what's a better shield, man? There's that silver shield that you get in World 5 at the very end. From one of those, you know, it's Black Phantom. That shield's really good. But no shield's got this sick life regen. Helps you out a lot. I'm a big fan. I gotta be careful here, though. Alright, rolling out of there. Gonna get a move on now. And there's actually more I want to show you, too. I mean, we've actually covered quite a bit here, you know, even at this point in the video, and I'm happy about that. There's also, well, what I'm going to show you now, and then, I mean, additionally, I've gotten killed by that many, many times. And if it happened in a cast, I'd really lose it. Oh, my God. there's the bird that you can trade with. That really annoying bird. He's kind of funny, I guess. But, I don't know, maybe I can get a shot of his tree. Because I don't think we're going to visit there, you know? Yeah, there it is. There's that tree. Yeah, the birds are flying around there as well. Yeah, so Sparkly, or I don't know, maybe that's his name in the other game. He lives there. You trade with him the same way in Dark Souls, you know, you just drop. He wants sparkly, twinkly items. And, well, I guess whatever meets that description, you know, he'll accept for a trade for all kinds of different stuff. Some useful stuff for sure, but you'd have to get a list of that online. Ooh, that hurt. That was a little bit careless. Okay, we're gonna actually grab this copper key that allows you to open and free should I show you guys? Yeah! Show us! Okay, yeah, well, I've shown you where Sparkly is. You just go up there. He's, there's no one really defending there. And then there's Ephemeral Eyes that would just be up to the left there. You can see it faintly. Oh, there's a bow up there too I want to show you guys. There's a lot in these levels, man. Okay. We've got a nice one-on-one in this corridor. He's a little sloppy and, you know, at a big disadvantage because he really just had those rolls going for him, at least skeleton type. And in such a narrow place, it's hard. There's a passage down there. I guess we'll go down there in a minute. Up here, we're going to be picking up a weapon that, you know, should come into play in the future. For sure. Okay, killing that guy off. Out here, being defended by, you know, just one archer skello here. Oh no, I'm such a jackass. Well, you know what? It's not a big deal. Why am I, like, complaining about that? It's, like, 2 feet away. I thought, I don't know, any fall in a Souls game, I immediately assume the worst. Like, instant death, starting the level again. But we're good. We're back. And, let's just try this again. Okay, he's dead. Composite longbow. You know, a decent bow. There are quite a few sort of below it. I don't know. I'm not big into the archery guys. I guess I'm showing you sparkly. Let's just do it all. Although bows definitely are important, come in handy at certain points. Of course.
You.
Here he is.
Give Spock.
So you can trade with him. You just drop items here and reload Spock the game and. He'll have traded. He lets you know what items are acceptable or not. Okay, this is tricky. Let's grab the ephemeral eyes, which we do, and then quickly, before this guy disappears... Oh no, I'm rolling in the wrong direction. He's gone, right? Yeah, he's gone. He got out of there. Those two rolls were pretty shitty, so... that guy escaped. Not the end of the world, you know. It's not even guaranteed that the... The shards that he's going to drop are even going to be useful to me. Not guaranteed, but... they can also really add up in weight, which is annoying. I'll kind of stay on top of that. Anyways, we've got two skellies right here. Oh, jeez. I got to be a bit more careful. Alright. One-on-one. I'm happy to engage. It's just... Usually when there's like two of them, obviously, and all that damage can stack up pretty quickly. Still kind of hesitant. Let's switch and do a quick heal. I think I've got some spice on hand, don't we, guys? I don't know. Oh, that was smart, you know? Full heal, followed by a full heal. Perfect. Where's that second skeleton? Got him right here. Oh no. Out of there. Okay. Oh, man. I'm just gonna heal. That was so close. I would have really liked to know my HP. It could have been single digits for sure. Okay, I think we have eliminated most of the threats in this level. We've got some healing grass. Now, like I mentioned, the copper key we picked up. We've got this merchant here.
You have us if I'm grave as thanks.
Okay, grave robber, oblige. What are we going to want to dump our souls into? Probably just healing stuff. He sells cloudstone if you need a merchant to sell you that. See, there's the short bow and the long bow, but I'm sure that the one that we picked up is even better than those, so whatever. And arrows, I guess we could grab some. Why not? You know, they sometimes... Oh, you know what? They also weigh quite a bit, so let's just think about this. We don't want to go nuts on the arrows. Let's just grab, I don't know, like 50. Sure. Good to have. And then... The cheaper moon grass, as much as we can get.
Satisfied.
It's okay, even with a bit of a cheaper moon grass, because we've got that regeneration as well. If you kill this mercenary, it will shift the world's tendency very much towards black. And that's what I did on an alternate character recently, and I actually recorded that. I was gonna die. Oh my god. I set these traps off sometimes, and I'm not sure where they're going to come from. And if you miss, you know, if you get hit by that first one, you're dead. Okay. Oh, that's good. This weapon we could definitely end up using. I used it a lot in Dark Souls on one of my characters. Oh, we got something else there as well. That's another Dex sword. Tons of weapons just out in the field here. Definitely go grab those. Is this trap? No, we already set it off. Okay. Okay, so we're picking up weapons. Why don't I just sort of identify that other one? This one. I don't know how to pronounce that, man. It ends in a J. It's a bit overwhelming for me. D is for dexterity, and it has a D in dexterity for the stat bonus. So yeah, dex sword. We're using what's normally a dex sword, but because it, you know, the game turned it into a crescent one for us to find, it no longer scales with dex. And we also picked up this Yuki Katana, deadly katana weapon, you know. So we've got lots of sick loot in this game so far. And yeah, if you're playing, I also index pretty much all the items and like major encounters in the description, so you can jump around and find any items you know that you might be looking for, or quest items, or people, NPCs, whatever. Now I'm going to show you the shortcut that very very popular and very powerful kind of shortcut. Simple roll, drop right off. Ooh, I'm not actually sure what that is on the other side. But here is that regenerator's ring, and let's just put that on. Oh, okay. So now that we put on the regenerator's ring, we no longer have the thief ring, so this lizard can actually see us a little bit faster. You know, from a bit further away. But using our R2 two-handed, we kill him off. See the Dark Moonstone? Like, I don't know if we're ever actually going to use that. But, yeah, we might. We might. I always am sort of considering what I want to do next in the walkthrough. And honestly, your feedback is really appreciated. Like, the suggestions or, you know, just let them know what you think. I use that feedback for sure. And, you know, in considering future zones, too, like, you can go anywhere you want in this game. All five worlds are open pretty much right at the beginning, so you can go and get whatever items you want and tackle any bosses you want. Pretty cool. Grab that Grave Robber's Ring as well. Kind of useless, to be honest, because it just makes it harder for Black Phantoms to see, which maybe would have some, like, tricky usage in multiplayer. Although, even then, like, that'd be pretty tough. Okay, let's just fight this guy off. You know what? Why are we gonna run away? Or run by? Let's just kill this guy off. So, it's pretty easy to get backstabs off. Although he will pretty much one-shot me. Especially with, like, that forward double katana attack. Getting a couple backstabs off now. And can we actually just finish him off like this? Yeah. Oh, see? Pretty nice. That's just like a nice one-handed overhand doing over half my health damage. I hope this boss fight goes okay, guys. We're going up against the Adjudicator, who is like considered to be one of the easiest bosses for sure. There are a few methods. Let's get rid of what we don't need. We don't need most of this stuff. Just put on a bunch of grass. We got lots of half moon, late moon, sure. Any changes to equipment before we jump in? Really, no. None. Let's just do it. Okay, so this is the melee method. Run down the stairs to the right. Get behind him. And I'll drop down. Now you just... Oh man, okay, I wasn't actually familiar with, like, falling rock from his tongue that can, crush you below. Okay, so all you gotta do is easily enough, chop at his wound there, Just some extra souls there. So yeah, I mean, if you stay just conscious of his swings, and it's pretty easy to do that just because there's such a big windup. Although that was very close. Yeah, you should be good. You should be good. All you have to do is, you know, chop away at his wound for a bit here, and then soon, you'll see what happens. I think it should just be another couple of chops. There we go. Okay. So then we're going to target this bird that's, like, replaced his head. This like, ogre, you know, it's... I don't know, how do you describe this kind of boss? It's an abomination! An abomination helmed by this, like, you know, little bird. This little Tweety bird, almost, you know? It's a yellow one there at the crown. And yeah, that's the thing that takes most of the damage. I wonder how his, how half his left-hand cleaver, became impaled in his stomach there. So we're doing pure R2, and I'm pretty sure that's the best way to do it. I don't know, for the moveset that we're working with here. Does pretty good damage. So hopefully it's just one more. Okay. Targeting. Come on. Come on. Oh, no. Maybe I could have timed that a little bit differently. I don't know. Stamina is really the bottleneck for damage output there. Okay. I think, basically call it on this one. Called GG early. I mean, this has been a pretty one-sided engagement. This guy has made quite the mess, though. His lair. Alright, that's it. This bird on top. This guy's tongue hanging out. That's it. Goodbye, my friend. He waves to us. And we did it. We did it. Under 40 minutes, we covered a lot of weapons. Most importantly, the Adjudicator Shield, very important shield. I mean, I think we're going to use it for most of the game, especially once upgraded. You know, we got the Swollen Demon Soul as well, and it slips my mind what you can use that for. Oh, no, it's the cleaver. Of course it's the cleaver, the butcher's knife. What is also considered to be one of the best weapons in the game, I'll make it, for sure. And I plan on switching the weapons that we use quite a bit, but, you know, we'll try it out. It's a really deadly weapon. You can't even upgrade it, but it's very powerful to begin with. And, of course, it looks like his cleaver that he was wielding. Yeah, what a crazy boss. Now, what we want to do is correct what went wrong in the last video. That NPC, that sorcery guy, snobby fellow, didn't want to actually teach us magic. And that's because our magic was too low. So we have to bring that up to at least 10. Also remember that the weapon we're using currently scales damage with magic. So we'll do more damage with that. I guess, want to dump too much more in there. I really think that we should just do endurance to up our equipment burden, which I think is quite important to get on early. Maybe one point into strength. Sure. And then... Okay, we might as well just do what, you know, every Souls player has to do. And I don't even want to dump all these souls right now, but we'll just... Yeah, that'll take a little while, but we'll just take enough so that we can level up one last time. So that is, basically going to do it for this video.
Soul of the mind, key to life's ether.
soul of the lost withdrawn from its vessel. Let strength be granted so the world might be mended. So the world might be mended.
Final point put into endurance.
Art thou done?
I'm not sure what zone we're going to do next. Last time I thought we were going to go straight into 1-2, which is Phalanx, Arkstone here. And, well, I kind of changed my mind because there was so much good loot for us to get in 4-1. So I think we covered that zone really thoroughly. Thanks a lot for watching, guys. And until next time, I'm Hunter SC. Take care. And peace out. Alright guys, this is going to be a bonus clip. I actually alluded to this at some points in the video, and what we're looking at here is a pure black world tendency event. These world tendencies are shifts you can make, and it changes the game dramatically. It's like From Software's way of adding replayability in a very creative way. I'm going up against a Black Phantom NPC, and I didn't even realize, but at the beginning here, I was screwing around, just pushing him. I realized you actually do a little bit of damage like that, and you can kind of spam it out, I guess. I don't know, I was messing around at the beginning. But don't forget, this is a really tough battle. I'm going up against Black Phantom Setsuki. He one-shots me. Every swing of his katana, no matter what it is, will one-shot me, unless I'm guarding with my sword, in which case it's not one-shotting, he's gonna two-shot me instead. I'm using enchant weapon on this claymore here, and this took me so many countless tries, but I was so stubborn and persistent that eventually what I'm showing you here is gonna be our successful attempt. Now when his health is below 50%, he's trying to heal, so he's not aggressive and he kinda doesn't attack as much, but so many times I would get him to like 10% health and he would pop a heal, instant full health, and what, I gotta like hack away at him 30 or 40 times again. I managed to avoid getting hit here, and you'll see in a minute. Anyway, so yeah, this is pure black. The pure black world tendency events are very hard. On black world tendency, the enemies have more health, they do more damage, they also give you more souls and more loot, but everything is tougher. And as you can see there, Shrine of Storms, pure black, it was only up there for a second, but you can see the world tendencies there. And I didn't know when else I'd sort of have an opportunity to share at least this specific one with you, killing off that NPC, getting the Hiltless, which is like a katana type weapon that can do very large amounts of damage, I think for dex builds more, but it also chops away at your own health when you swing it, unless it's a critical attack, in which case it's pretty deadly, of course. Anyways, I wanted to close out with this. I'm just such a fan of the tendency events. It sort of elongated the life of Demon Souls for me a lot, because you know, you could explore all the areas again on pure white and pure black, and there's new items, new little subquests, you know, these Black Phantom NPCs that are really tough, and then upcoming here, just Black Phantom regular monsters that, can prove to be a problem as well. And then in the white tendency world, you know, like, people are more friendly, like, you can find that same NPC Satsuki there, but he's in human form, and there's some lore there, and like, a quest thing, so, this stuff's cool, and it was only gonna, this was gonna be the only chance to share it with you guys, so I wanted to include this at the end of this episode. We'll be working on episode 3 next, so keep an eye out for that. Thanks a lot for your support, guys. Take care until next time. I'm Hunter SC. Peace out.